So let's learn the famous Sweet Child of Mine by Guns N' Roses. The entire song's on D major. You could possibly say that it's like a D mixolydian because it has the 7 flat. So that's D, E, F sharp, G, A, B, C, D. Right? It's not the C sharp which you would get because there's a lot of the C major chord in the scale. So let's get started. It's basically a lot of chord progressions. Actually, 4. It's not that much. But let's figure that out. And at the end, I'll also tell you the guitar hook which you can play on the piano. So the first part of the song is that guitar lead. So I'll teach you that later. Stick around. And let's just first look at the chords. Happens throughout the guitar hook, throughout the verse section. Na 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 G na 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 and cry D. And the pattern I'm applying for pretty much the entire song on the piano is what I've written down here, which is 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and this is like the snare drum hit, which is optional. So 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and na 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 da da na na da na 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 na. Okay, so let's see how it again works on the piano. Na 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 na. Also, just check out how I'm playing the C chord. It's like C major, but I'm adding the 9, which is the D here, right? So let's do that again. C with D. Of the chord in the left hand, G, D, and then the chorus, oh, sweet child of mine, that's A, C, D, A, C, child of mine, D. This is the entire chorus. And then whenever the guitarist plays the hook, which is like the first solo before the actual solo. I think there are like 4 guitar solos or something in this song. Wow, that's a lot of solos. Anyway, so you'll have the first guitar solo, which is on the same chords as the verse, which is D, C, G, D, which are the same chords you also play that hook. Right? So for the first guitar solo where he goes... G. D. Right? And then I think that goes back to the verse. And then again you do, "Woe, sweet child of mine." And then the same hook happens again. Right? D. C. Child of mine, whoa, sweet love of mine. Okay, and then the solo gets a bit heavier, right? Where he goes, those chords are 4 times, and you can find that here. So, this is like the second or the heavy solo before the next heavy solo where it gets really heavy. So that's E minor, C major, B seventh, A minor, and it goes on. minor. Let's see how it is on the piano. E minor, na na C. B7, this is how I'm playing B7. Na 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 da da. Do E minor, C. B7th. It gets really heavy, which is before the bridge. Which is like that where do we go part, which is going to come up next. So the heavy guitar solo and the where do we go chords are identical because it takes it to the bridge where that where do we go goes on and on, right, for the entire song. Till the end, isn't it? So, the guitar solo going heavy again. Let's look at the chords. E minor. G major. A major. That's C, D, G, E minor. C for two counts, D for one count, and G for one count. Let's do that again. And also on the piano, since the song doesn't really have piano, you can perhaps, instead of playing full chords, you can even play, whenever things get heavier, you could play, just play the power chord. The power chord removes the third from the triad. Makes things sound a lot thicker and a lot heavier as we think. E minor, G, A, C, D, G. So I'm playing full chords in my right hand, and if you can, you can, instead of the octave or along with the octave, you can also add the perfect fifth. So for E, it'll be this, E, B, E. G major will be G, D, G. For A, it'll be A, E, A. C, fifth, D, G. The same chord progression carries on to the where do we go part, but where do we go doesn't start that heavy to begin with. It goes where do we go, where do we go, where do we go now, where do we go, then it builds up, right? Where do we go now, I go from the choppy part to the build up. So with the choppy part, you can just do short staccato hit at 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and where do we go, 4 and where do we go now, 1 2 3 4, 1 and then go staccato for the first three chords, right? Build it up. Get louder. That the very I think the whole band plays that triplet lick, which I've written down here. So somewhere at that heavy part, it goes to that triplet lick, which is. I think the word is now, if I'm not mistaken. Na 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 now, sweet child. Na na. very last time he goes, so that's the outro which I've written here. So that's E minor, sweet child, G, sweet child. That's A major, C, D of mine. Ends on an E minor and the drummer does his fancy crash cymbals and you're pretty much done, right? So it's an interesting song to play on the piano, primarily because I guess it doesn't have the piano. Let's conclude the lesson by just looking at that guitar hook which I played at the beginning, right? Let's see if we can also do that on the piano. So the guitar hook I have written here. So just follow the notes in the tutorial. But anyway, so let's look at it. Each lick or each line is played into two, as I've mentioned here, right? So let's see how that goes. Two, that's D octave. Two, two, two. That's line one, and I'm doing it with the pedal. Do follow the piano picture for the pedal movements which I'm doing. So, otherwise it'll sound choppy. You can also, flip some fingers around. I'll just do it slower. Or, then coming to line two, very similar to line one, right? It's just the D was there in line one, and then for line two, it's just a move to an E. So let's just do line one and line two. Okay, and now line three, which is G, D, A, G. So it's essentially just the first notes changing. So that's line three for you. G. Repeat. And then come back to line four, which is exactly the same as line one, isn't it? So the whole thing again with the bass. D. C, line 2, line 3, G with line 3's stuff, line 4, and then the same thing repeats again, but then line 4, instead of playing this one, we just do the last time line which I wrote, which is very simple. E, D, E, F sharp, G, F, F sharp, E, D. So that A is like a pedal. It keeps repeating, right? The last D. So D, C, G, D. At the last D chord, you play the bass D. Got that? E, D. And in between all these high notes is just a pedal A. D. Let's try and look at the whole lick, the whole hook. E. Sorry. E there and C here. Let's do that again. C in the left hand. Now G in the left hand. Back to the D. Then repeat that. Oops. And then C. G. And then end with so that's basically the guitar hook, which you could play on the piano if you need to, or if you can, or if you want to. Otherwise, you can just play the chords, I guess. Right. So this is Sweet Child of Mine by Guns N' Roses. It's an amazing song. And as a piano player, I hope you can have some fun with it, because there are not too many rules to follow except for that rhythmic phrasing where you go 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. 4 is the snare, which is optional. So lot of chord progressions, very interesting. It's on like a Mixolydian sound, which is a flat 7 of the major scale. Very popular in rock music in general to have the flat 7 happen, right? Very inspired from the Beatles, going all the way down to everyone, right? And the song has a lot of dynamics, doesn't it? It gets really, really heavy at the end, and it's like a nice rock, groovy rock song in the beginning. It gets really heavy in the end, right? So hope you guys have some fun playing this track. Cheers.